As of October 2nd, 2022, there are 50 volcanoes actively erupting on the planet. One of these erupting 50 is the Kilauea volcano in Hawaii, whose eruption just passed a major milestone. Its ongoing eruption, which began on September 29th of 2021, has just passed the one-year-long mark. Although this is somewhat impressive, it does not compare to Kilauea's famous 35-year-long eruption, which lasted from 1983 to 2018. In fact, since 1800, there have been 5 additional distinct eruptions of the Volcanoes 39 during this time span that have reached that milestone. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In Japan, a new explosive eruption began at the Nishinoshima Island volcano, sending a plume of ash visible from satellites several kilometers into the atmosphere. Meanwhile, in Alaska, the alert level of the Trident volcano was raised from green to yellow, due in part to a possible magmatic intrusion. And, in Turkey, a swarm of earthquakes struck underneath the Tendürek volcano, potentially representing a change in the overall volcano. For context, the Tendürek volcano is located in far eastern Turkey, where it is 34 miles or 55 kilometers southwest of the far more famous Ararat volcano. Tendürek is quite an interesting volcanic complex, as unlike the vast majority of volcanoes within the country, it is a shield volcano. Although it has not produced as many confirmed eruptions as some other nearby volcanoes, I suspect that Tendürek has been more active than current records suggest, simply owed to 450 square kilometers of land being covered by dark black lava, which looks less than 30,000 years old, and the number of cinder and spatter cones with only minimal to moderate levels of erosion present. Regardless, Tendürek is somewhat notable because it produced Turkey's last eruption in 1855. In recent years, this volcano has produced semi-regular, albeit low-magnitude earthquakes, potentially due to a slow influx of magma into the volcano's magma chamber. The latest earthquake swarm began on October 1st at around 7 a.m. local time. During the next 5 hours, about 20 volcano tectonic earthquakes occurred, the largest of which was a magnitude 2.5. Strangely, these quakes occurred on a seemingly west-southwest trend, which parallels two of the volcano's most notable vents, suggesting that some underlying fault or dike intrusion might be involved. Although the ongoing earthquakes cannot be definitively linked to volcanic activity, the shallowness of some of the quakes being less than 5 kilometers or 3 miles deep on the southern flank of the volcano is quite suspicious. Meanwhile, in Japan, the scenic Nishinoshima volcano produced a new volcanic eruption, sending a plume of ash 2 kilometers into the atmosphere. This represents the volcano's first eruption since 2021, when it produced a 2-day-long eruption in August. Although no one lives in close proximity to this remote volcano, it is quite an interesting complex as it has consistently been enlarged without much erosion between most of its eruptions. This is likely due to the abundance of lava this volcano produces, as in contrast, many other shallow submarine or small island volcanoes produced higher quantities of ash. The ongoing eruption seems relatively consistent with a high-end VEI-1 or low-end VEI-2 eruption, and has caused water discoloration to the island southwest, which is visible from satellite. Although not much of a danger, it could disrupt some regional air traffic. Within Alaska, the alert level was raised at the Trident volcano from green to yellow on September 29th. This change was made due to a prolonged swarm of earthquakes which began underneath the volcano on August 24th. These quakes got progressively shallower over time in what appeared to be an example of a textbook magmatic intrusion from the suspected depth of the crust mantle boundary. After the rate of earthquakes declined, they spiked once again on September 22nd when 40 earthquakes occurred in rapid succession, largely at 3 miles or 5 kilometers in depth. Additionally, via an INSAR dataset, I detected likely ground uplift to the south of the volcano, indicating that if confirmed, it proves that magma is moving shallower into the crust, and I speculate that molten rock might currently be at between 3 and 9 miles in depth. Here is a quick list of every volcano which is currently erupting. Also, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting but could erupt in the near future. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you wish to support this channel, consider becoming a patron on this channel's Patreon page.